That's how I remember Korea. Not only that, when I was in the Methodist Church, we have Dr. Kim. I remember very clearly Dr. Kim was the president of the Methodist Church in Korea. And he was invited to Fiji in 1996. And I believe I will share this because it's very significant to New Methodist Christian Fellowship. And I remember I was head of evangelistic department in Namaka Circuit. And that year, that Dr. Kim was invited to be one of the guests in the Methodist Church. And I praise God for the opportunity to get close to Dr. Kim, the president of the Methodist Church. He came and do some the training in the Methodist Church in Airport and St. Henry. And it just happened that I, from time to time, come down to Suva to listen to some teaching, especially on church growth and evangelism. And he was speaking on those areas. I remember he was talking about the five steps to have a church growth, or five steps to encourage a church to maturity. And he was talking about getting off tradition and culture. Number two, he was talking about the church must tithe. For church to explode in finance, for church to use finance wisely, he was saying that the church must tithe. And most of us know that we come from a church background back in Fiji. Mainline churches, they don't tithe. But Dr. Kim, the president of the Methodist Church here in Korea, he emphasized the church must tithe. And number three, he was talking about instrument, that the church must use instrument, especially for young people, and to use it in the evening service. We can use the choir in the morning, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, as normal, we use the choir because we have choir. But in the evening, we must use instrument. That's to cater for the young people. Young people love music. They blend well with music. As time goes on, they love music. And number four, he was talking about using the young people for evangelism. And this is through skit and drama and testimonies. And I praise God for those ideas. And he was saying that's what he did. He did in Korea. And most of the circuit in Korea, or the division in Korea, they use it. And that's why they are very dynamic compared to a normal Methodist around the world. And the last one, number five, he was challenging the preachers back in Fiji while he was doing a devotion, that the preacher of the gospel must keep the holiness of God. So those are the five things that he normally share during the devotion, during some teaching, in order for the Methodist Church, as we know, it's a mainline church, to in competition or come to par with the Pentecostal movement back in Fiji. And I remember when Dr. Kim was about to leave Fiji, and I was acting tal-tala in the Namaka Circuit, Tamatatako Namaka, and I was asked by the divisional superintendent of Methodist Church in Nandi, who was the late Reverend Upeti Utoni from Manolewu. And he asked me, because I was acting tal-tala in Namaka, if I can arrange somewhere in the airport for the farewell to our guest, which is Dr. Kim. I'm sharing this because of my connection to Korea. And while I arranged for the VIP at the terminal, and I remember the late Reverend Thomas Kamelain was there, Reverend Moses Embernerara from the Division of Muda, and Upeti Utoni from the Division of Nandi, and I believe the head of Men's Fellowship of the Methodist Church, he was there, and Taltalangase Nemani Thakathaka was there. There were a few others, they were there. And while I was preparing and we were sitting around in the VIP in Nandi Airport, and then I asked the president of Fiji if I can ask Dr. Kim of any farewelling message, especially because I was looking after MYF in Namaka. and I was very active in the youth. So I was allowed to ask the Dr. Kim of by request. So I asked him, Dr. Kim, my name is Antonesa Vulaono, and I'm acting at the moment of the Taltala in the Namaka Circuit. I want to ask you a farewelling message for us, especially at that time the Pentecost in Fiji were vibrant. And I want the youth to enjoy the same thing in the Methodist Church. So he said, okay, ask the question. So I asked him, what will be your departing message to me as a young one to be a Taltala in future to come? And what will be your message? And I thank the Lord. He shared and said, I will not come away from the five steps that I shared in Suma during the training, during the devotion. The five steps to have a maturity in the Pentecostal movement, or to rise to another level that you can be confident in a church explosion or church growth. And he said, number one, he said, when I drink kava, I don't like the spirit in that kava. He said, I don't like, the church must stop drinking or using that kava to be part of the church in whatsoever. He said, I don't. There's a spirit in that mud water. He mentioned mud water. He said, that's number one. Number two, the church must tithe. Number three, the church must use instrument to cater for the young people because they love instrument. Number four, for young people to be used in evangelistic drama and skit and testimony and action song because the young people are very vibrant to go into the world. So he said, use the young people. And for the fifth one and the last one, he said, for whoever wants to be a preacher, whoever wants to be a minister of the gospel, they must keep the holiness of God. Praise God for that insight. And I took that, I wrote a letter 1 month later. I wrote a letter to the church and asking them, reminding them of the five steps that Dr. Kim, the president of the Methodist Church in Korea, highlighted, not only in the training during the week-long training in Suma, but also as a departing message from Nandi International Airport. But that was 1996, and there was no reply to my letter because that letter was addressed to the president, and copy the Taltala Gase Vasose Nandi, and also copy the Taltala of Namaka Second. And I never knew that one time I'll be leading a church, New Methodist Christian Fellowship. And I look back now, when I talk about Korea, then I realize the five things that Dr. Kim was talking about that I'm using now in the New Methodist Christian Fellowship. That is 1996, about 6 or 7 years later, 2002, when the church started. We cut down cover, the church tithe, and using the young people, using the instrument, and we stand by the holiness of God. So for those of you that are watching this clip, whether through the My Television or whether through the Facebook, it's an insight that we really need to dig deep into. I mean, you're talking about Dr. Kim from Korea. His congregation is about 1 million, and that is greater than the whole population of Fiji. So if that man stand for the righteousness of God and talk about something powerful, something that has value, I'm standing here in the soil of Korea and in the land of Korea, the land of beautiful people, and they really explode in their industrial, and it's competing with Japan, it's competing with Taiwan, and so wonderful to see people like this, that they have the principle of working hard, a principle of Jesus Christ, and yet they are also faithful in their worship. And at night, if you go out into the city, if you go out at night, you will see Red Cross everywhere, because the Red Cross indicate all the churches, whether the Catholic, Seventh Day, or any Pentecostal. You'll see thousands and thousands and thousands of Red Cross in the cities. the big city, the cathedral, or the small, just a small church. Every church, every worship center, they'll have a Red Cross. So it'll be good to share this with you as we are here in Korea, our last night, or our night here before we travel tomorrow to the Holy Lands. And I encourage you to continue to tune into to this Facebook page, Souls to Jesus or New Methodist, because we'll be preaching live, we'll be sharing live from the Holy Land beginning from tomorrow, as we will be traveling tomorrow. So I share this information with you because I'm in Korea, and I believe it's a best place to share what Dr. Kim. And I enjoy coming to Korea from 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009. So about five years in a row, continue to come to Korea. And that's where I see the prayer mountain. Nearly every church in Korea, they have a prayer mountain. In the mountain, you go to whatever church. We were looked after by Presbyterian. They have a prayer mountain. They have something like a hotel in the mountain. But when you go to the Yonggi-cho, oh, that's a different story altogether. So from the land of this beautiful place called Korea, we want to encourage you. There are times God have a special plan for you. You need to find that plan. You need to find that purpose. And we are here at Grand Height, which is about only 10 minutes from the international airport, as we are about to go tomorrow back to the airport and on our way to the Holy Land. So from Korea, we say, God bless you. Have a wonderful time in Jesus' name. Amen.